This video is brought to you by Sporlin. Quality, integrity, and tradition.
Today's complaint is that we have a hood system that it's randomly turning on and off, and it's after they had a power outage yesterday. So at this time, everything's on, and the fan switch works, the light switch works. But it didn't sound like this hood started up. Very interesting. This is my motor starter cabinet. So what happened was when I turned the fans off and then turned them back on, there was a delay. And there is no motor starter here, but what it could have been, the makeup air unit does have a small delay. So it could have been the makeup air unit that I was hearing. But so far, everything down here, all the motor starters are on. You can tell by the position of the little chingus right here to the left. And this one's pulled in. Okay. Interesting. So I turned everything off again. And I just turned it on. And everything's actuating as far as contactors go. Nothing's tripped. This circuit board has got a couple buttons on it, so we're gonna check to see maybe if we can see some faults. I don't know really what I'm doing here, but we're gonna see. So we're gonna hit menu, configuration, menu, system bypass, info, temperature, configuration. Let's go to info, fault history, there you go. Let's see what other options we have. Fault history, yeah, pretty much. So fault history, enter, and it says PCU fault, okay. But I don't have a date here, so I don't know when that happened. Okay, let's scroll through. I don't see any other information here. Temperatures, enter. Let's see, the room temp is 88. Temp sensor. Number 2, 71. Number 3 is 62. 466, 554, and drop in. So it doesn't look like we have any bad temperature sensors. Menu. Okay. Huh. So the PCU fault is interesting. We'll have to figure out what that is. I'm gonna jump on the roof and check the fans before I go any further. Watch out for these PTO or whatever, these rubber roofs, whatever they're called. Right now, they're icy, so it's like an ice skating rink. Be very careful, this is what I'm talking about. You will slip and hurt yourself. And usually, where you hurt yourself is not when you fall, or it's not when you hit the ground, it's usually when you react to the fall, and you like contort yourself in a weird position to try to catch yourself. That's when you damage things, pull muscles and stuff. So these are my exhaust fans. I'm gonna jump up here, check the belts real quick, see if there's anything funky going on with those fans. I have a hunch. I'm wondering if, because they told me they had a power outage, I'm not seeing anything wrong. I did find some loose belts and I'm gonna replace those and get them going. But they were saying that the hoods were turning themselves on and off. And I'm gonna call and verify with CAST service, but Captive Air's tech support. If they had a power outage and they didn't turn the hoods back on, this is my theory, and I don't know if this is true. Right here, okay? If they didn't come back on and hit the fan on switch, the hoods would turn themselves on via temperature. The temperature of the heat coming off would manually turn the hoods on, is my assumption, the way these things usually work. So if they didn't turn the power switch back on, the hoods would turn on, but then when they got slow, I mean, again, I know I'm reaching for the sky, theoretically, the hoods might shut off and then turn back on when they sense temperature again. It's a possibility because I'm not seeing anything else wrong. And like I said, I'm gonna call Captive Air Tech Support real quick and just run my theory by them and see what they have to say. So I believe, again, this is a hard issue here, but I believe that my theory is confirmed. So after talking to Captive Air Tech Support, I'm very worried about this room temperature, number one, being 99 degrees. It is not 99 degrees in the building. This shouldn't be a hood temperature. This should be an actual room temperature. I'm worried that that says 99 degrees because nowhere in this kitchen is at 99 degrees right now. And that, my understanding, could lead to the problem of the on-off thing. So possibly when they had a power outage, my theory is that when they power turned back on, the hoods went into auto mode, which happens, okay? If I unplug this guy right here, the hoods will power down, and then I plug it in, they will automatically turn on without me hitting the hood switch, because they have a safety feature where it looks at the temperature and it fires the hood up. When it's in the auto mode, my understanding is that it uses a temperature differential to turn the hoods off. And as those two numbers get together, closer together, the room temperature and the hood temperature, it theoretically could turn the hood off, but then turn itself back on because it senses high temperature from their fryers that would theoretically still be running. So I know this is a whole big theoretical thing, but it's running right now. So I need to trace out where this room temperature sensor is, because I got to figure out why it says 99 degrees. Everything else reads somewhat of an accurate temperature. That's a hood temperature. That's possibly a hood temperature because they're not fully cooking right now. They're only cooking on their fryers, which would make sense. And then this one, I believe, is possibly a back hood, which would make sense. They're not using that right now. So theoretically, this could be the problem. The problem is I just need to find out where that is. That's this sensor right here, and it goes up into these, and I got to trace out where it goes and where it's mounted at. That could be our problem. For now, the solution is that we have to make sure that the kitchen staff understands they have to manually turn the hoods on. If they don't, they'll auto turn on for safety, but theoretically with that temp sensor being bad, they could auto power off too, if that makes sense. So I gotta trace this guy out. I'm starting to wonder if it's just a bad sensor placement because the temperature is dropping as I'm sitting here. So I gotta trace out where this sensor is, but interesting. I found it. It's over here. This is a really bad location because we have a supply grill right here and it's just blowing on it. So that's why the room temp was so high. We'll talk to them about relocating that sensor. So this is just a theory because I had a feeling that it had something to do with an auto feature. So what I'm gonna do, they're cooking right now. So the hoods are hot. So when I hit this button, it should not turn the hoods off, and it didn't. But look, it tried to turn them off, but then the hood control board took over and said, no, it's too hot. And it went into auto mode. But my understanding is that auto mode uses a temperature differential between the hood temperature and the zone temperature or the room temperature. And if that room temperature is getting hit with the heater vent, I would think that maybe that had something to do with the auto powering on and off. Again, I could be completely wrong, but I'm just trying to make sense of what's going on here. So I don't want this to say auto. I want this to say on. Because now it'll run until someone turns it off, until someone turns it off. But when they had a power outage yesterday, my theory is that this thing turned off, but then when the power came on, it auto powered on and then went into that auto mode. And then it was just a weird freak incident where it looked at that room temperature sensor and somehow caused some issues with the powering on and off. Again, this is just a guess because this morning the hoods are working fine. So, you know, we just kind of do our best to investigate and figure everything out. I also covered my ass and let the manager know that that's just a theory. It's just an educated guess. And, you know, there's really no way to know for sure unless they call me again and say they have an issue. So, but I am going to work on moving that zone sensor. I can't do it right now, but for now we just leave them in fans on and then we should be good. I was kind of guessing with the zone sensor. So what I did was I found it on the bottom over here. It's the bottom right, these two right here. And I pulled the plastic cover and traced it back. And then I noticed that right here, this gray jacket is going up, and I followed it up into the attic, sitting right here, and then just kind of looked and watched where it went. Saw it go up on top of there, down over there, and then I noticed that, look, it's going right over, I know it's probably hard, but it's coming down the duct and going right over to that wall. And then so that's when I walked over to the wall and saw that there was a zone sensor on the wall. So that is my room temperature sensor. And because they have a door open right now, it's dropping in temperature, which really made me so look. It says 72 right now, but when they shut that door and the heater vent blows on it, that's going to go back up to 90, 100 degrees, maybe even higher. This place has several belts that are worn out. They're loose and they're just worn, so it's just going to replace them. But the thing is that by the time I got to these belts, it's about 10:45 and they're already cooking downstairs. So you have to pay attention. Some kitchens you can do this on where you can shut down a hood, some you can't. This kitchen will be okay. It all has to do with the amount of heat coming out. Certain restaurants have char broilers and the hoods are really close to the cooking equipment. So the heat's just gonna be insane.
This one's not one of those. I can do this, but I do have to be quick, okay? I don't want to do it for very long. So what I do is I have everything ready. Maybe the belt will go right on, but maybe it won't. So I got my wrenches ready. This way I'm not looking for stuff. I'm prepared for the worst. Screwdriver, towel, got everything ready. Belt right here. We're gonna shut it off, change the belt. And if I have to adjust the motor, because again, remember, pulleys are never adjusted to tighten a belt. Pulleys or sheaves are adjusted only to change the speed of the fan, and you don't just go doing that. You never adjust a pulley to tighten up a belt. The belt is tightened by the motor bracket moving left and right, whatever the mechanism is, okay? So we have everything ready. I'm gonna turn it off and change it out. When it comes time to leave, I don't care what you have to do, double, triple, quadruple check, make sure everything is back on, even if it's not something you worked on. Always double check. If something's off, don't just go turn it on, but I mean, check, make sure. There's nothing worse than someone saying, you were just here, now this isn't working. So I double checked all the exhaust fans. You gotta trust your gut. If you're going down the ladder and your gut says, oh man, I should double check one more time, then do it. Listen to yourself. Everything's back on, ACs are all back on. We're gonna wrap this up. And I'm gonna come back and relocate that sensor, but I just don't have time to do it today because they're already open.
So our jobs are not always 100%, you know, they don't fall in your lap as far as the diagnosis goes. This was one where everything was working when I got there and I had to make some educated guesses, okay? It's been about a week and a half since this service call. I haven't had any return callbacks or anything, okay? So I'm pretty sure I had a good idea of what was going on there, but I had to make some educated guesses. And sometimes we have to do that. Sometimes we have to stop and think, step back, look at the big picture, and try to think what is possibly going on here. When I walked in the door, the manager gave me a really critical piece of information. He said, because I walked in, I shook his hand, and I said, hey, how's it going, bud? So what's going on? And he goes, oh, you know what? Yeah, I said, you know, he goes, we were having a hood problem yesterday, but everything's working fine now. And I said, okay. I said, yeah, but they called me last night asking me to come out today. And then, you know, I asked him, I go, is anything, you know, is this new? Has this happened before? And he goes, no, it's never happened before. He goes, but it was kind of weird because it happened right after a power outage. Key information right there. Again, that communication with the manager is key. Talking to them and you know, just getting on their level, asking them how things are going, asking him if this has happened before. And then, you know, he was comfortable. And then he just, you know, he didn't think it was anything important, but he said, hey, you know what? We had a power outage. And then it was just kind of weird. It started doing this weird thing. And that kind of was sitting in the back of my head. Now, I didn't focus completely on that, but it was sitting in the back of my head while I was going through my troubleshooting steps. I certainly found some belts that were loose, you know, took care of that. But it was always in the back of my head. And then, you know, I went in there, I've worked with these hood systems before, I know how this one works. And so I kind of had an idea, okay, here's what's going on. What happens when they put it in auto mode? And in my head, I know that they'll turn themselves off and turn themselves on. So then I had a hunch and I called and I confirmed it with tech support. And again, even after talking to technical support, we aren't 100% sure because I couldn't duplicate the problem. I couldn't get it to happen again. But I went through all the steps that I could possibly go through. And the tech support guy, you know, he kind of said, yeah, I guess I could see that happening, you know. And I'm pretty sure that's all that it was. Now, I have not been able to go back and move that zone sensor yet. So that is something that I'm working on with the customer. We're going to go back. It's coming up. It's the Sunday before Christmas. So we just don't have time right now. But we'll definitely get back there and jump on that. But you know, again, big picture diagnosis, guys. Step back, look at the big picture. Don't just assume, you know, yeah, they had loose belts. And one guy can go in there and just say, man, they just had some loose belts to tighten them up. Couldn't find anything else wrong. You know, maybe he would have had another problem. Maybe he wouldn't. But I discussed with the customer, basically held their hand, walked them through the process as I was working on things. Before I called tech support, I said, hey, look, this is what I think is going on, but I'm going to call the manufacturer and confirm with them. I'm kind of putting them into my diagnosis and letting them know my thought process so that way they have more confidence in me. And, you know, I honestly told the guy, look, it's not doing whatever it was doing. So I'm making an educated guess here. I flat out told him I'm making an educated guess, but I made it logical. I said, look, this is how the hood system works. I explained it to him to the point that where he was going, you know what, that does make sense that I guess, you know, and he doesn't understand how this hood system works, but I explained everything, you know, on his level. This is what happens. When it gets too hot, they turn on. So I guess in theory, because that zone sensor is right there, and I showed him and he goes, oh, wow, that's right next to the air conditioning vent. And I go, yeah. So then he could kind of understand and it builds confidence, okay? Even if it turns out to be something else, it still builds confidence with the customer. Communication is key, guys. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to watch this video. Understand something, guys. I am not perfect. I make mistakes. I have to make educated guesses. Sometimes they're wrong. In this situation, it seemed like it worked out okay, all right? I do live streams Monday evenings, 5 p.m. Pacific time on my YouTube channel. You may already know this. You may not. Come check them out. And also, I'm starting a new YouTube channel called HVACR Tools. It will be linked in the show notes of this video right here. It'll be like the top thing right when you open it up. And I'd appreciate a follow, subscription, whatever. I tentatively plan on posting a video the first of the year, of the new year, I should say, where I'll be reviewing tools. So really appreciate it, guys. Leave me some feedback. Let me know what you think, and we'll catch you guys on the next one, okay?